All right, so today is going to be a very, very, very exciting day. I woke up and had a dream that I was going to do an eating challenge where I could just eat whatever I wanted for the entire day. Instead of having a dream, turn into a reality. So let's go. We got 2 dozen donuts. I got one box for my family, so they'll eat those. And then this box is for me. Oh yeah, look at these babies. So, Yum Yum's Donuts is a small business donut shop and bakery. They have donuts and croissants and breakfast sandwiches, but their donuts are absolutely amazing. And the reason they're amazing is because of the size, the taste, the consistency, and just the overall freshness. So I got a ton of donuts here, all different flavors. So I'm just gonna try to pound as many as I can. And then whatever I don't finish, I'll eat later throughout the day. All right, definitely excited about this. I'm gonna start off with the first, just classic chocolate iced donut. Very gooey, which is a good word to use when I'm eating donuts. Next up, I think I'm gonna bang out just this powdered donut. Nice thing about the powdered donut, you can dip it in the coffee. Double banger right there. I think the most donuts I've ever eaten in one shot is 6. So we'll see what happens today. Try to get a good mix of filled donuts and I guess, open hole donuts, as we'll call them. Just cause if I got all filled donuts, that was gonna fill me pretty fast. Just a solid donut all around. I like a chocolate icing, that little vanilla drizzle on there. Got the cream filling. Strawberry iced. Look at that. This guy here, classic glazed donut. You know, you just can never go wrong by a glazed donut. I think a glazed donut is just the easiest way to judge the standard for the bakery or donut shop you're at. They have a bad glazed donut, pretty much setting you up for failure. Basically, like when you go on a date with a chick and she starts talking about her ex-boyfriend on the first date, you know it's probably not going to go too well after that. Okay. I think I'm going to do this cherry bomb. Next one I'm gonna do is gonna be, this guy right here. This is a French apple. So basically it's just a donut with vanilla icing on top and filled with apple pie filling. Delicious. Probably gonna do one more and then take a little break, you know, shower myself up, and I'll save those rest for a little afternoon treat. But donut PR for sure. I don't know the exact calories, but I think it's pretty high. Starting to get the carb sweats for sure. And then we'll eat the rest as the day goes on. I didn't want to make myself so sick to my stomach before I work out. That just wouldn't be a good idea. And I want to utilize these carbs as best as possible to get in a nice session at the gym before we commit some more atrocities. Reason I'm picking this, it's a nice one to finish on. Goes great with coffee. The other 3 that I have are heavier, definitely. And I just wouldn't enjoy it as much. So, you know, you're gonna do these eating challenges, you're gonna suffer a little bit, but you gotta enjoy yourself just a little bit if you're trying to get through it for the rest of the day. 9 total donuts down. Feeling very content.
Alright. This salted caramel. Delicious. Very good.
We gotta have Mr. Zeke say hi.
Ooh, say hi, Mr. Zeke.
Ooh. All right, so kind of just giving you guys the rundown of the morning. So typically this is Saturday. And on Saturday I hit leg day after I'll have my first big meal. This is just regular schedule stuff, so I don't wanna really get too far off from what I normally do. The only thing that's a little bit different is that I got a walk in with the dog before training. So my steps, right around 4,000 steps on an average day. I minimally will hit 12,000 steps, anywhere between 12 and 20,000. So I'm trying to get more steps in throughout this day just to help kind of burn some calories, burn some energy, help digest the food. So I'm gonna train now and then we'll go and dive into some food.
Crosskeys Diner in Doylestown, by far my favorite diner across the entire planet, actually the entire galaxy. So if you're ever in PA, Bucks County, Doylestown, you gotta come check this place out. A small little place, you know, small business supporting them. But we got some scrambled eggs, we got a giant stack of sour cream pistachio pancakes, some home fries, and then we got this thing called the Southern Scramble. I don't even know what that is, but I'm gonna eat all of it, and I'm gonna have to guesstimate how many calories. I'll probably undershoot it. It just means that I'm gonna have to eat even more. And then I gotta make sure that this guy comes out and approves that I ate all this food, and we'll go to the next place. So let's get it. Make sure you guys check out Krusty's Diner. I'll put all their tags right down below. Go to town, check it out. Oh, and if you didn't see, can you zoom in on this butter? Show them how much butter's on there.
That's like at least, I don't know, a quarter stick of butter. That's a lot, wouldn't you say?
That's a ton.
That's a ton of butter. All right, let's do this.
All right, so finished everything besides the potatoes. I'll give that to Zeke. I'm pretty stuffed, and I'm trying not to actually make myself sick to my stomach because I have a long day ahead of me. So just getting full and being content. But I still think I did some damage. Amazing, amazing pancakes. Whoa, excuse me. I thought I was gonna throw up there. I didn't though. And then there was some sort of scramble thing I got. Came out with like sausage cream beef, and it was fabulous. I've never actually eaten that ever. And it wasn't what I thought. I just kind of read it really quick and it sounded good. And I was very, very pleasantly surprised with what I ate. So now it's time to go do a walk with Mr. Zeke or maybe a bike ride. All right, so the Cross Keys meal is finished. Moving on to the next one, which will be after I take my dog for a walk. So right now we are at 6,133 steps. So I'm trying to get 2,000 to 3,000 more. And then I got a nice, a big fat meal to come back to, which I will show you when we get there. All right, so the walk is done with Zeke. Put me at around 11,000 steps, and I was listening to the Ronnie Coleman Joe Rogan podcast. You should check that out. Now before I pick up some other treats that I'm gonna have later this evening, I gotta stop with my truck at Willy Wonka Land. You'll see what I mean in a second.
With a spin, traveling in the world of my creation, what we'll see will defy. explanation.
Oh no. What is this?
The best pizza in the world, Joe.
Oh my gosh. Mango and Mango pizza. Let's see these bad boys.
Mango and Mango.
Where's it from?
Jersey Shore, Ocean City.
This pizza came all the way here for me?
All for you.
Oh man, let's see how many slices I can eat, baby. And we have the amazing Chloe Shea in the house. You know, I call her when I need to get my pizza cut in a nice, beautiful fours.
It's beautiful.
Look at this. Oh yeah. Do you think I'll eat the whole thing?
Easily.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
How many slices are you gonna eat?
Two. One or two.
All right.
Can I eat the whole thing?
Let's do it.
Well, here I go. See. So you have it, finished the entire Manco and Manco pizza. My biggest criticism has to be that this crust is a little bit dry, so I'm not gonna eat it, but who better than I than two amazing dogs that I'll show you them in a second, but they're gonna eat that. I wonder how many calories it is. We'll add it up, we'll put it right down here in the bottom, but now I'm gonna take a little siesta, contemplate my life, and get on to the next challenge.
Take it nice. This is Mr. Toby, the old and wise dog of the house. We love dogs here.
All right, before we commit to more atrocities, we must go for our walk and get our steps in, and then we're heading off to somewhere else. Where are we going after this, Chloe?
We're going to Taco Bell.
Oh, Taco Bell. Oh.
Can I have three soft taco supremes? Ooh, do you have like a, is there a sugar-free Baja Blast?
Yep, we have Baja Blast.
Yeah. Oh, baby. Yeah, I want that. Can I have two chicken supreme chalupas?
Okay.
And then a crunch wrap. Supreme? Wait, do you have like these like little cinnamon things?
Unfortunately, we stopped selling those at 11 a.m. every day. This was shorted. Do you like cinnamon twists instead?
Yes, I would. Wait, can I have another Baja Blast? I'm sorry, I forgot. I think that's it.
Okay, it's gonna be 27:18 at the first window.
You're the best, thank you.
All right, so we got Taco Bell. Honestly, haven't been to Taco Bell that many times. I really never know what to get on the menu. But the common theme for this menu that we selected was
Supreme.
Anything that I saw with the name Supreme, we got. Besides these, I don't know if these are cinnamon twists. They're very light. Actually, I'm very unimpressed, I'm not gonna lie. I thought they were gonna be way, way better. No, that's a joke. Okay. I think this is a chalupa. What are these? Supreme. These are Supreme Chalupas. These are Supreme Tacos, I think. Yep. And then this thing. I don't even know what this is. I just saw the picture. Take it out for you, too. Ooh, fancy. Fancy. And just a ton of sauces. Because who doesn't want to get sauced? I want to get sauced. Oh, and how can we forget the signature Baja Blast? Really cool because this is sugar free, so I feel good about it. Mmm, delicious. That's actually really good. Wow. Alright, so let's see how much damage we can do. So I stated what I was going to be doing today by adding steps. Yesterday, I just did a little bit more conditioning, took my bike for a ride,
and everything else was pretty normal. I didn't starve myself or anything like that previous to this or change up anything, you know, that abnormal in my routine. Tomorrow, I'm just going to eat when I'm hungry. I am probably going to guess that I'm not gonna be anywhere near as hungry as I normally would because all this food's gonna hold me over tomorrow. But if I am hungry, I'll eat when I'm feeling hungry, and it's gonna be mostly protein and lots of fluids. And I'm definitely gonna get in a training session. Lifting weights is good, and then probably some sort of cardio. But I think in the next couple of days, my weight will go back to where it was. Maybe it'll be up by a pound or something like that. But by the end of tonight or tomorrow, I'm guessing I'm probably gonna be up 8 to 10 pounds. So we'll see what happens. But that'll be a lot of water weight, a lot of sodium, and actual mass of the food in my stomach. And so, yeah, that's what I'll be doing tomorrow. I'm actually gonna throw up. Whew. Whew. All right, to conclude this day of eating before I step on the scale for the final weigh-in, we have the last donut. Cleaned myself up because I just felt like a fat blob with oil perspirating out of my pores, and it was probably actually oil that things were cooked in, and just felt really gross. So let's hound this, hop on the scale, and then...